when I get the light, alone in this heaven. Oh, baby. Please welcome New York State Assembly member and vice chair of the Democratic National Committee, Michael Blake.
Good morning. Good morning. Buenos días, damas y caballeros. Mi nombre es Miguel Blake, asambleísta para Distrito 79. Oh, you got surprised. I didn't think a Jamaican could speak Spanish, did you? Look at that right now. We are here with the critical moment and the responsibility of breaking the cycle of poverty. And I come to you as someone where this is very personal for me in so many ways. You see the picture of the cute kid? Man, that's a cute kid. That's me. My mother, who is here in the audience, who raised four boys, me being the youngest child, came here from Jamaica, overcame homelessness, beat breast cancer, was able to endure the challenges to make it for us here today. My daddy, who passed away in 2013, was a janitor for 29 years at St. Barnabas Hospital. In that journey, went to public school, PS 79, 118, DeWitt Clinton, had the honor of working for President Barack Obama. We certainly miss the leadership of President Obama, which transformed opportunities to demonstrate what could be possible when we help young people get those chances. And in that journey, you recognize that you have leaders, such as Dr. King and JFK. JFK, who said very powerfully, so long as there's one child without milk, so long as there's one family without a decent home, so long as there are aged persons without pensions, so long as there are working mothers without fair wages, struggling farmers without income, so long as there are overcrowded schools, inadequate hospitals, and families on relief, so long will be the need of the Democratic Party, and so long will be called upon the responsibilities of leadership. It matters who you have as leaders. As Dr. King made very clear for all of us, in the end, we'll remember not the words of our enemies, but the silence of our friends. We don't have the luxury to be silent in these moments. Or, as Bryan Stevenson made very clear to all of us, the opposite of poverty is not wealth, the opposite of poverty is justice. And so when we talk about how are we going to break the cycle of poverty, we have to approach it with a place-based mindset and approach of situation, action, results. Situation, how do we break it down? The Bronx, which is where I represent, the South Bronx in particular, the most diverse county in America, 89.9% likelihood that any two people you meet be a different ethnicity, but we endure the challenges when it comes to poverty. $38,000 being our per household income. It's not going to work when you have that kind of scenario. With that other opportunity of diversity, though, you cannot be silent. When you think about what's happening in New York, think about this. 1.8 million people are living in poverty, essentially the equivalent of the population of Philadelphia. It doesn't stop there in the United States. How can we be a place where 38 million people are in poverty and recognizing the challenges of poverty? And you have to assess it among people of color, where 33 states, Hispanic and black children are at two times the level when it comes to white children. We say we cannot be silent. Along the world lines, when you see that extreme poverty is still existing, how can this be the place for us that we stand here and come together at the Concordia Summit, where you recognize that the same Park Avenue here in Manhattan is the exact same Park Avenue in the Bronx? Something has to change when inequality exists in so many places around the world. That is the reason why we say we cannot be silent. So long as this inequality exists, we must do more. We have to demonstrate what can be possible when breaking the cycle of poverty. 400 years this year since enslaved Africans were brought from Africa to the United States and then had to endure thereafter Jim Crow laws and continue, as Michelle Alexander says, the new Jim Crow era. We cannot be silent in our communities. That is how we break the cycle of poverty. So the action is the vision of what we have called 3-2-1, the three E's of economic development, education, and equity. Make sure we help people get opportunities with entrepreneurship. Make sure education is focused on a cradle to career mindset. How do we focus on equity, not equality? Because so many communities don't have the resources that they need. When we talk about entrepreneurship, the Involve Award, Involve Global being the focus effort that we've collaborated with. It started in so many other places. American Entrepreneurship Award, we like the claps, we like clapping, that's good right there. It's that opportunity for a 10-year commitment now in the Bronx and across New York City to help zero interest loans so that young people can get an opportunity they did not have before. Involveglobal.org for that opportunity a little further. Education, My Brother's Keeper. We are the only state in the country with the My Brother's Keeper program, where we are helping young men of color get a chance who were not getting an opportunity before. When one out of every three black men and one out of every six Latino men are serving time in prison, something has to change. And so we put resources to be dedicated in changing the narrative and saying that we will make sure you have that opportunity specifically so that you can see teachers that look like you. Because when you have someone that looks like you and comes from your journey and comes from your walk, things are different and better in your life. Learn more about what we're doing through our My Brother's Keeper program. But then equity, meaning we have to focus on justice. Criminal justice has to be true justice. That's the reason why we now have raised the age so that 16 and 17-year-olds are not tried as adults any longer. That's the reason now we have open discovery so that the defense actually knows what the prosecution has on them. We are tired of people coming from poor communities not having the same chances just because of their last name or the money in their pocket. That is what happens when poverty exists. Too often, wrong decisions are being made, but it's time for us to make the right ones. When you have housing inequalities that exist, when you have a young man like Khalif Browder who took his own life, when you have the opportunities where people need book bags, that is how you break the cycle of poverty. Change the game for everyone by giving them a job, showing them the possibilities. In the Bronx, the home of hip-hop, doo-wop, and salsa, we're connecting entrepreneurs with music, but also with food and culture, so it's connected to what's going on in the communities in a very practical way. But the results, come to the Bronx on Wednesday. You can see what we're doing in the Bronx. The Concordia Day of Engagement is coming to the Bronx on Wednesday. We welcome you, we enjoy you. Lit Bar, which you see there, is an independent bookstore led by Afro-Latina, Noel Santos, who is the first and only bookstore that we have in the Bronx when Barnes & Noble's closed down. And right next to it is Bistro, a hip-hop-themed restaurant and bar to create opportunities so that you could see what could be possible when you come to the Bronx and transform the game in the Bronx. Politics impact policy. You cannot ignore that. 787, that's the area code that comes from Puerto Rico. So our Puerto Rican sisters and brothers, when they came to the States, we were able to connect them to opportunities on the ground in Pennsylvania, in New York, and in Florida. Or Organizing Corps, which we encourage you to learn about that, where 1,000 young people of color will be trained across this country, no matter who the nominee is next year, so that they can be ready for the moment. And that's one of the reasons why I'm running for Congress, because you need to have new leadership that's going to DC to be our voices, to focus on affordability so that you change area median income, so we focus on what's going on the ground, so you have a cradle to career approach, so that you eliminate student debt but actually connect you with job opportunities, so that we have a public jobs guarantee so young people can have a job and be connected to the jobs that come after. Eliminate cash bail so you're not struggling and you're wondering how too many times poor people are suffering because of injustice. That is not who we are. Comprehensive immigration reform for the Latino community, for the Caribbean community, for the African community. All of us can win and win together. Believe in the change as we've shown in West Africa. Show what could be possible in France. Show what happens in Greece. Show what happens in all of our communities. Show them what can be possible in all different aspects. Now, if I've gone too fast for you, it's because I'm Jamaican and I speak fast. You're going to be just okay. But it shows you the opportunity, what happens there. The resources that we leave with you will give you that opportunity. Mama, you liked that line, didn't you, right there? It shows you what can be possible. Poverty prevention with Robin Hood. I encourage you to learn about what Wes Moore is doing with Robin Hood to change the game and transform the opportunities that exist that's there. Follow us on Twitter at MR Mike Blake to learn more about how we can connect you with that, or join us at blakeforcongress.nyc. Go a little bit further. When it comes to entrepreneurship, how can you see the Millennial Compact that exists? Make sure when you take a picture, use a flash. I'm a dark brother up here. When you talk about criminal justice reform, new Jim Crow law, and saying what's going on with new Jim Crow and Michelle Alexander and creating those opportunities so you can learn a little bit more, or understanding that you have to have the connection so that you're not locking someone up. Maybe if we help someone have a book bag rather than arresting them for a dime bag, things will be better in our communities. When you come to housing, create the spaces when it comes to housing to open up more doors for young people, because if you can keep a home and have a home, it will transform what happens in those communities. All of these things lead to education, where obviously David Banks and Soar and the Eagle Academy have created more opportunities for some people across our communities, black and brown young people who didn't have a chance before. When I talk about education, I want you to think about the visual of Jacob Philadelphia. Jacob's father, Carlton, was a national security staffer. He came into the Oval Office when we worked for President Obama and said, "Mr. President, both of my children have a question, but I don't know what the question shall be." He said, "Well, help me to understand this." He said, "Mr. President, I just got a new suit. Mr. President, I just got a haircut. But Mr. President, I was wondering if I could touch your hair to know if it feels like mine." Breaking the cycle of poverty is not just about the policies. It's about the young people. It's about finding the new Jacob in your life. So then we go back to your respective communities, you can show what could be possible. My family went from no house to Jamaica. My mom was homeless and opened up doors for all of us to give us a chance. So if I could go from no house in Jamaica to the Black House in Northwestern, to the White House in D.C., to the State House in Albany, to the U.S. House in Washington, anything can be possible for you. So I'm showing you what is possible when you break the cycle of poverty. Show them that so long as we still have poverty, we will not be silent in the pursuit of equity. We still do believe that your block won't block your blessing. Your zip code won't deny your destiny. That's what happens when you break the cycle of poverty. Tell them that we still believe in jobs. We still believe in young people. We still believe in what can be possible. If you still believe, I leave you with the words of Fat Joe: nothing can stop you. I'm all the way up.